back in 1937, the East Palestine Kiwanis Club was interested in helping the high school band and put on a benefit program. The purpose of the film was an advertising sales scheme to produce money for high school bands. Uniforms. At that time, the public funds were not permitted to be spent for uniforms. And the Kiwanis, being a civic organization with the idea of helping out, they sold space on film, so many seconds, for X number of dollars, perhaps starting at $25, depending on how much film was run, possibly running up as much as $50 for so many minutes running film. And then they sold this program to the business people in East Palestine, in Petersburg, surrounding farm dairies. They paid all of the expenses and turned over something in excess of $1,000 to the high school for the purpose of furnishing band uniforms for the band at that time. We have a city presented to the Queen. Majority of the youngsters are not identified. This is Ted Hirsch in his younger days, of course. And the key to the city. Ross Chick. The Methodist Church. Mr. Fullerton, the Reverend Don P. Mueller, Methodist minister at that time, and this is Margaret Coil. Bill Davis on the right. Chamberlain, preceding him, of course, was the Reverend Boies. The Lawrence Grocery Store with Harry Lawrence Sr., Pete Harry Lawrence Jr., and Paul McGuckin. Store were Willis Lawrence, Anna Jean Seidel, Morris, Paul McGuckin, and Bill Southern. Southern Drugstore, Bill Southern, Russ Eberhardt, Virgil Young, Bill Southern, Senior, Junior. Newspapers, school books. He winds up the storefront. Jake Eisnick, Harry Ort, the building alone, Hugh Kleckler, and John Eisnick. J.H. Connolly, tin shop. Kennedy, possibly with John Rohrman, John Connolly. Light Pharmacy was Homer Southern, Charles Nightingale. Seems to run in my mind that at that time they gave away a bicycle and a wagon, some kind of a prize setup they had, and they had a great number of contestants. Adam Bott clothing store with Adam Bott and Paul Marks. Clothing, shoes, hats. The Rook and Broad Meat Market. Clayton Smith, Homer Rookenbrod, Al Forney, Walter Trapnell, Eleanor Beale, now Ashbaugh, and in 1937 the new high school was being completed. The grading was done at a cost of something like $600. The old high school building. Some of the students might be recognized. June Hill, Mary Mason Dagren, Regis Archibald, Earl Sykes, Quinn Frostnut. Bryant, Clayton Schindler. Teachers in the entire school system with Charles Paulus and Alma Southern. Someplace in this group you can perhaps locate Dick Kearney and Red McCarthy. Quite busy. With Frank Moon in charge of production. The plant was operated by Herb Schmidt. This is Martha Van Dyke, Sam Houston, Carl Hublot. You recognize Marie Hegelmeyer Houston. Out the wedding cake. Followed by Kenneth Geiger, the American Legion Band. From the American Legion Hall. which is south on Market Street. At Huck's Dairy Store, then known as Tech Products, June Hauk. Savings Bank. With Joe Chamberlain entering the bank, on the left is Bob Grove, the center was Ruth Rudloff, Zilk Ben, Joe Chamberlain the president, and Elizabeth Harris. At Irwin Brothers Grocery Store, Frank brings out a first box and Jim carries a second box, loading them into the truck. Jim was the taller of the two. He's always proud of the quality groceries. The city insurance. Charles Grove talks with Gary Fowler and Audrey Galbraith, the secretary. Common Hardware. Bob Wolfs. Newman McConnell in front of the truck, and Joe Adamson on the other side at Bacon Strohack Lumber. Three standing against the wall on the left is Kirk Bates, McCarthy in the middle, and Mr. McConnell on the right. The employees of the Electrical Refractories Company at the east end of East Clark Street, with the dye shop employees, and then the office force comes strolling out. There's Clarence Williams, Fred Owen, Heck Moore, and Jack Turner. At the East North Avenue School, wrestling on the lawn. Mildred McKnight. Florence Simon, Mary Houston. Change it to Hunston. Anita Bloor Coleman, Bertha Wilson. Polarized Company. John Snyder is loading the truck. Archibald Jones, Sr., with his dog that he spent many hours training. Brothers. George Niesel sitting in the sun deck chair, ably assisted by Paul Hankison driving the tractor. Notice the steel wheels. Side, her husband, Paul Hankinson. George Niesel. Gas station, George Pancake on the left, Roy Gilmore in the center, and Fred Gibson on the right. Street. Patricia Hawk picking flowers in the yard. Off, police hat. Background, Mary Mansell in front, Ruth Davis with the braids. Tom Howard in the background at the old mill, Harry Rohrbaugh in the cab of the truck. John Lewis looking under the hood of the car. Frank Schooley in the background. Gentleman with the white coat at the inn. Petersburg, operated it for quite some time and very successfully. Looking over the products and OT himself. Trying to find a better one for Ted. Palestine. Check out the new store. Himself, check. Ted Hirsch, the safari hat, Harry Fraween, the center, Chick on the left. Chick Atkinson, Charles Grove, Homer Ruckenbrod, Clyde Britton, Jack Turner, and at Jenkins Appliances, Red. Jenkins on the left. Black hair, delivering in the Ford truck, and Pearl Eagle Mead, and the light straw hat, Sam Lowry, at Lowry's Furniture Store. Up the awning for the day as son Jay looks on. At Aikenhead's Ice Cream, they hitch up the pony to the ice cream wagon Ralph Henry was driving in those days. Clyde fills her up. Hart, Paul Britton, Mrs. Clyde Britton, Ina Britton, and Jerry Fowler paints a sign on a Chevy truck. Justison's Dairy. In the glass milk bottles. At the Lincoln Hotel. Bought Mr. and Mrs. Howard Day. And at Oliver Funeral Home, Virgil Hall on the left, Vincent Oliver on the right. Kenmar Furniture employees. No North Heights Dairy, operated by A.C. Hayes and his sons. A.C. poses in the white hat. Wesley on the left of the three at the East Palestine Cemetery. Elizabeth Davis. With the flag, Ed Hum. Reverend Boies on the platform, Jack Turner on the right side. Thank you.